welcome to the Siloam Baptist Church. And for those of you who are joining us on live stream, you are welcome also. Hallelujah. In the words of our African ancestors, once you stop by the house, you are family. So welcome as family. This morning, way of announcements, we have our Wednesday Bible study at noonday, and also the evening Bible study in the fellowship hall, and you can also join us online for that at free conference call. Operation Christmas Child shoeboxes can be picked up today and returned by October 31st. $9 will be mailed with each box so that donations are accepted and appreciated in any amount. You can also give online. Mark your calendar for Saturday, October 2nd at 10 a.m. for Scriptures and Prescriptions, a gathering of the whole church helping us through the mental health challenges of this time. All right. This time we'll have our opening scripture and prayer by Sister Kathy Evans.
I'm reading Psalm 34 this morning. A Psalm of David, when he pretended to be mad in when his son drove him away and he departed. But I picked this psalm for two reasons. One, it's going to be a theme of an upcoming women's retreat. And also, this psalm is a prayer and a praise asking God to deliver his people, and a testimony that God will and has delivered his people. Psalm 34, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. They looked to him and were radiant, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried out, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear him and delivers them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in him. Oh, fear the Lord, you, his saints. There is no want to those who fear him. The Lord, the young lions lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Come, you children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. Who is the man who desires life and loves many days that he may see good? Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. The face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. The Lord is near to those who have a broken heart and saves such as has a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, But the Lord delivers him out of all of them. He guards all his bones. Not one of them is broken. Evil shall slay the wicked.
Yes.
And those who hate the righteous shall be condemned. The Lord redeems the souls of his servants. And none of those who trust in him shall be condemned. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you for your word, Lord. Thank you for your promises, Lord. Thank you, O Lord God, that you hear our cries, Lord. And that you deliver us from all of them. Oh, Lord God, before I utter another word, Lord God, I just want to lift your name up and praise you.
Yes,
because you were great. Because you were mighty. Because you were good and kind and faithful. Because you were full of love, Lord. Because you were sovereign, Lord. If that alone, Lord God, I give your name praise, oh Lord God. You are perfect in all your ways, oh Lord God. And we honor you and we bless you and we magnify your name this morning, oh Lord God. We know, Father God, that we fall short, Father God, day in and day out, Lord God. We try to be obedient. We try to live according to your word, oh Lord God. But we are fallible humans, oh Lord God. And we fail, God. And we confess, oh Lord God, that we fall short of your perfection, Lord God. But we ask, God, that you will just cover our sins, oh Lord God, with the blood of your son, Jesus, oh Lord God. Count it toward us as righteousness, oh Lord God, through Jesus Christ, oh Lord God. And we thank you, Lord God, because your word says that if we confess that you are faithful and just to forgive us of all our sins. Father God, and we bless you and we thank you, oh Lord God. We thank you, oh Lord God, that time and time again, oh Lord God, that you wash us up, you pick us up, you dust us off, God, and then you gather us to your breast, oh Father God. And we thank you, Lord God, and we praise you, oh Lord God. As even as you said in this psalm, oh Lord God, many are the afflictions of the righteous, oh Lord God. And we know, Father God, we see it all around us, oh Lord God. There are sick, God, deplorable, harmful diseases, oh Lord God, attack us, oh Lord God. But through the blood of your son, Jesus, Lord God, and his stripes, God, we declare we are healed, oh Lord God. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord God. You know the inner workings of our bodies, God, because you created us, oh Lord God. You, Father God, we ask, oh God, that you will touch all those afflicted, Father God. Those in the hospital, Father God. Those among us, Father God, that can't make it out of their homes, oh Father God. We ask, God, that you will just visit them, God. Send your Holy Spirit. Send your healing. Send your encouragement, Father God. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord God. That even right in this moment, Father God, they feel your fresh wind and your fresh fire, Father God. In the name that they are encouraged, Father God, to keep on holding on, oh Lord God, to see what the end will bring, oh Lord God. We ask, oh God, that those that are confused in their mind, Father God, that they don't remember yesterday, that they don't understand what's going on today, God, that you will just touch their minds, God, and bring a moment, Father God, of clarity and revelation to their minds right now, Lord God. Let them see, Father God, who they are and who you are, God. And feel your love, Father God, and your divine, Father God, wisdom, God. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord God. Father God, we see, God, the devastation, Father God, of the earth's groanings, Father God, with the hurricanes and the earthquakes, Father God. And see, Father God, the tornadoes, God, that have ripped apart people's homes and their lives, Father God. We ask, oh God, that you will send provision, Father God. Everything they need, oh Father God. We depend on you, Father God. So we are asking, God, that you will use the government system, Father God. That you will use, Father God, those that have much, Father God, to bless and to help those that are in need and don't have enough, Father God. Father God, we ask, God, that you will send every resource, Father God, to help those rebuild, Father God. We ask that you will hold back any disease, Father God, or any bacteria or spread of anything, Father God, from the water that had covered the land, Father God. We ask that, Father God, that you will comfort those that are grieving, Father God. We know that there was loss of life, Father God, during these tornadoes and hurricanes, Father God. But there was also loss of property, Father God, that people grieve, Father God, precious memories, Father God, that will never be returned, Father God. We ask that you will comfort them as well, Father God. Heal the brokenhearted, Lord God. You said that you were near the brokenhearted, Father God. So we ask that you will come near, Father God. And those, Father, that are grieving loved ones, whether it was from these disasters, whether it's from COVID, whether it's from old age, whether it was from crime, Father God, we ask that you will surround them, uphold them, hold them close and comfort them, Father God. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Father God, we ask, oh God, that you will send peace in the land, Lord God. There are wars and rumors of wars, Father God, and there's even just crime, senseless crime in our streets, Father God. We ask that you will send peace in the land, Father God. Help us, oh Lord God, to value one another, Father God, and to love one another as you have loved us, oh Lord God. Help us, oh Father God. You said love covers a multitude of sins, oh Lord God. If only we would love one another, Lord God, as you have loved us, Lord God. So we ask you, God, to send peace in the land, oh Father God, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord God. And Father God, I ask, God, that you will just send your Holy Spirit in the midst of this sanctuary today, oh Lord God. This is your holy temple, oh Lord God. And Father God, we ask, God, that you will just have free reign in this place today, Lord God. From the preaching, to the teaching, to the praying, to the singing, to the dancing, oh Lord God. Have your way, oh Lord God. Lean in, Father God, and be pleased by what your children are doing today in this place, oh Lord God. We want you to be glorified and magnified and lifted up in this place, oh Lord God. We want, Father God, the power of your Holy Spirit, Father God, to change lives, Father God, to heal, Father God, to break the chains, Father God, that bind us, Father God, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord God. Today, oh God, we want today, oh Lord God. Have your way, God, in this place, oh Lord God. We make room for you, Lord God. We move out of your way, oh God. Even if it's not on our plan, Lord God, we give you free reign, oh God, to have your way, oh Lord God. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord God. And Father God, we ask, God, that you would touch that soul, God, who doesn't know you, Father God, who is seeking, Father God, answers to why am I here, Father God. We ask, oh God, that you will touch them, Father God, that your word would burn in their hearts, oh Father God, and that they will cry out, what must I do to be saved, Father God? And Lord God, I want you to tell them, Lord, that all they have to do is call on your son, Jesus. Hallelujah. And they will be saved. They will be healed,
yes.
And they will be delivered, Lord God. Father God, in my last prayer, Lord God, this morning, Lord God, is as the service closes, Father God, and we walk out of this sanctuary, Lord God, I pray, oh Lord God, that we carry your spirit with us, Lord, and that we are obedient to your word, Lord God, that when you say, comfort, with the same measure that we have been comforted. Lord, give out of the abundance of the blessings that you have given us, Lord God, that we bear one another's burdens and sorrows, Lord God, and rejoice with everyone, Father God, who is rejoicing, Lord God, that we take it to heart, God, and that we do it, God. We do it, Father God, from the moment our foot touches the street, God.
And Father God, that you will be glorified in all that we do, Father God. That all that we say, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless your name.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus.
I feel your presence.
Bless your name.
I feel your presence.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All nations whom you have made shall come and worship before you, O Lord, and they shall glorify your name.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That heaven will praise your wonders, O Lord, your faithfulness also in the assembly of the holy ones. Hallelujah. It is good to give thanks to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And to sing praises to your name, O Most
High.
O come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. And then come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. Our Lord, our God, is the way maker.
Hallelujah.
He is the promise keeper.
Hallelujah.
That's just who he is.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And the prayer we just heard this morning encapsulated all of that.
Hallelujah.
But in case you didn't catch it, somehow your ears was closed, your eyes were shut, we want you to open them right now to understand he is keeper.
the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Yes, Lord, way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You're a way maker. Light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You're a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper. Light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you, Lord, I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, mending every heart. I worship you, Lord, I worship you. You're a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You're a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Your way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every life. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, meeting every need. I worship you, Lord, I worship you. You're a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. You're a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. Thank you, Jesus.
Search the Lord, you ask him, you acknowledge him. We just want want to declare his goodness today.
Yes.
Hallelujah. There is none like him. There is none above him. Hallelujah. And we just bless your name today, Lord, because you are good. You have not forgotten us. You have not left us alone. Hallelujah. And your mercy truly endures forever, regardless of what's going on, regardless of the storm. Hallelujah. So we're just going to praise your name today, Lord. Hallelujah.
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 Lord, you are good and your mercy endures forever.
Thank you.
God. I wish I could do that. Now it's time for the word. Scripture reading is taken from Matthew chapter 25. We will be reading verse 41a. Matthew chapter 25, verse 41a. Then he will also say to those on the left hand, depart from me, you cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. After the prayer of consecration, my best friend, the Holy Spirit, will be teaching you from the subject Gehenna, hell. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless these, your people. Impress upon them the true meaning of this place, of hell. Help us to understand it. Help us to live in respect of who you are and what you have done for us. B'shem Yeshua HaMashiach, in the name of Jesus the Messiah, amen. Jerusalem, the city, sits on a series of mountains. There's Mount Zion, and that's the original city that David conquered. And as you go up from Mount Zion, there's Mount Moriah, where the temple was built. So when you see in the Bible, it says that Jesus went up to Jerusalem for Passover, now you know what it means. He went straight up a mountain to get to the higher elevations and dwell in the city. Since the city sat on a mountain, there were sheer cliffs that went down and a valley below. So as you come down from Mount Moriah to Mount Zion, you'll reach the Pool of Siloam, which is what this church is named for. As you venture out of the city gates and go down along the southwest portion of Mount Zion, you enter the Valley of Hinnom. Terrible place. Solomon. In 1 Kings chapter 11, verses 1 through 5, scripture says, Solomon loved many strange women, foreign women, together with the daughter of Pharaoh, women of the Moabites, Ammonites, Sidonians, Hittites, women which God said, you shall not intermarry with them, and they shall not intermarry with you. Solomon cleaved to these women in love. He had 700 wives. And 300 concubines. Oh, concubine, that's just a side piece. That's just a woman you have kids with. She's gonna have my baby. To build up the family. So Solomon had 1,000 women. Something's wrong here. You know, you can be turned over to a reprobate mind if you don't listen to the Lord. Solomon was warned about this, but he persisted. And he just may have been turned over to a reprobate mind. Nevertheless, this situation had catastrophic meaning and events to the nation. These weren't ordinary women. These weren't women of God. These weren't women who came up under the Torah, under the five books of the law. These weren't women of the covenant. They were pagan women. They were witches. They were sorcerers. They were women who practiced divination. If you have one witch in your house, in your life, you got a major problem.
Amen.
She's not listening to God. She's listening to hell, to Satan. She's bringing up incantations. She's on the Ouija board.
Yes.
She's going to seances.
Yes.
And dabbling with witchcraft. If you have one woman doing that in your life, you got a problem. Solomon had 1,000 women doing this, and it brought catastrophe to the nation of Israel. These women couldn't practice their religion in the temple because David had left a legacy of praise and worship that went on for many generations. They couldn't practice their divination in the temple. So they went outside the city of Jerusalem to the Valley of Hinnom. Oh, Lord. So terrible. All along cliffs in the side of the mountain. These women built what they called Tophet. image of Baal and other gods, they put these into the clefts of the mountain. These images had the heads of bulls and the bodies of men. They sat there with their arms out like this. Their eyes would be hollowed out, and their mouths would be wide open, hollowed out. And they would build these enormous fires inside these clefts. And the fires would rage up, and they would have their incantations and say their praises to these gods. The image would heat up. The altar would heat up. Become molten red. Flames would be shooting out the eyes of these gods and out of the mouth. People would bring their kids, their infant babies, to these places. They'd give them to the priest, and the priest would lay them on the altar, or lay them on the god. The baby would scream, "Ah!" because he was burned. His hair would burn, his eyebrows would burn. Finally, his skin would burn. They cooked the babies to death in a human sacrifice. This didn't happen once. Didn't happen a few times. It happened thousands. Thousands of times people sacrificed their children to these gods. How many of you know behind all of this murder was Satan? He wanted to be worshipped as God. Are still there in the rocks. If you go to Israel today, these burning pits, these Tophet, they're still there. Righteous kings like Josiah tried to destroy them. He turned them into garbage heaps, and they burned garbage there. Maggots and worms came out of the rocks. Hinnom Valley was so disgusting of a place, they renamed it Gehinnom. Everybody say that.
Gehinnom.
Say it again. Gehinnom. Gehinnom. They named it hell. Killing babies, murder of infants. The Canaanites were the most egregious offenders of this practice. There was a Canaanite colony in North Africa called Carthage. Archaeologists in excavating the ruins of Carthage found 30,000 jars, about the size of an urn. In these jars burnt remains of human children. That was the Canaanites. They practiced this everywhere they went. The Canaanites became known as Phoenicians. The Phoenicians practiced this. This is why Jesus called the Syrophoenician woman a dog. She was a dog. She was practicing satanic arts. That's probably how her daughter became filled with a demon spirit. When you dabble in witchcraft, when you dabble in astrology, when you practice these satanic arts, open up your life for satanic invasion. Yes, sir. They will come in your life and wreak havoc. You've got to exorcise them, and there's only one way to do it. The blood of the Messiah Jesus. This was the Valley of Hinnom, place of murder, place of death. When Jesus came and began his ministry, he talked about hell. He called it a place of weeping and gnashing of teeth. 8:12. In Mark 9:44, he said it was a place where worms never die and fire is never quenched. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I submit to you this. Jesus came from the Father. He's the Word of God. He's the Son of God. He was there in creation. He was there when God made this place of eternal punishment for Satan and his angels. He knows what it looks like. And he gave us clues 11 times in the Gospels. He compared hell to Gehenna, the place where these babies were burned, where these worms dwelt. I submit to you, God is going to give Satan payback for all the evil he has done in the earth. Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord.
Yes,
I will repay. He's going to repay Satan for every last murder, every last rape, every last adultery, every last murder of a child that he has performed. Same way those babies burned on the altar, he's going to burn forever. The same way worms and maggots ate the garbage of that place, Gehenna, they're going to eat and gnaw at him and his angels. They will be screaming forever. And the souls of sinful, unrepentant men will go to this place also. There's one wonderful fact about this message that you must understand. In our text, Jesus, when he comes to judge the earth, he's going going to say to those on the left hand, depart from me, you cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil, Satan, and his angels. Hell was not made for you. Hell was not made for me. It wasn't made for mankind. It was made for the devil. We don't have to go to hell. A provision has been made that we can avoid this suffering. Jesus came to give life, eternal life, to all who would ask for it. All you have to do to get into the kingdom of God is ask for it. Ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be opened. It all fits together. Isaiah 53. Who has believed our report? And unto whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? The arm of the Lord, the Zeruah. The arm of the Lord, the Passover lamb, that little bone on the tray of Passover represented the lamb who was slain, and the blood wiped on the doorpost and the lintel of the homes, so that when death came through, it passed over the people of God. Jesus is the Zeruah. He's the outstretched arm of the Lord. His arms were outstretched when he hung on the cross. He's the salvation of God. All we like sheep have gone our own way, but the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Because of his atoning death, because he was God's scapegoat, we're free. We're free. We don't have to experience hell. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I got news for you. Hell will never see my face. Hallelujah! Wants to receive this gift of eternal life, who wants to have their sins erased, covered over by the atoning sacrifice of the Messiah, King Jesus. Yeshua HaMashiach. Father, we ask right now that that would take place. Inscribe their name in the book of eternal life. Repeat after me. Father, in Jesus' name, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, erase my sins, Lord. Cover them over with his blood. Make me a new creature. And fill me with the Holy Spirit. I belong to you now, Lord. I belong to your kingdom. My name is inscribed in the book of eternal life. I will live in your kingdom forever and ever. And ever and ever. And ever and ever. Give the Lord a shout out for your praise. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, I feel in my spirit. Somebody give their heart to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
The doors of this church now open. If you have never given your heart, if you don't have a church home, you don't have a church home, and you're looking for one, we will love you here at Siloam Baptist Church. Is there one? Just raise your hand. Is there one? No? Praise the Lord anyway. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All right. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
It is now time for our communion service. And we will transition into that area of the church.
In some respects, it was a fearful word. Because sometimes truth causes us to awaken to fear. But if you know Christ, and Christ knows you, hell is not in your future.
Right.
Heaven is your future.
Amen.
Because God has made provisions for his children. Now, if you're not one of his children, please, please take this message to heart. Because this may be the last time that the invitation will be extended to you. And when it's over. But if you receive him as Savior and Lord. Then, my brother, then, my sister, hell is not your home, heaven is. And the reason why we know that is because of this table. Because this table represents love to the highest degree. For my Bible says, he who knew no sin became sin that we may become the righteousness of God. In other words, we've been made all right by the power and the blood and the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. Can you look somebody? We don't touch each other anymore. If you look somebody, look at somebody and say, brother or sister.
Brother or sister.
Brother.
I am
a child of God.
A child of God.
How about you?
I am
a child of God. How about you? It is this table that gives us the audacity to say that I am a child. Because of our technology and where we are right now, we do not have hymn books in the pews, I believe. And so we do not have copies of the church couplet.
It's on the screen.
On the monitor.
It's on the screen. Oh, okay. Praise the Lord. So let us collectively read the church. Let us read together.
Having been led to believe by the Spirit of God, to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior, and on the profession of our faith,
Lord of earth, a moon can stand.
Personally, the Minister Bill will lead us in prayer. Mm-hmm.
Father, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord God, we ask that you will bless this table. You have blessed us with the forgiveness of sins and cleansing from all unrighteousness.
Yes, Lord.
Now we ask, Lord, that you would hover over this table and bless us, Lord, as we partake of the body and the blood of the Messiah, that we will remember his sacrifice,
yes,
what he has done on our behalf, amen, to save us from the place called hell.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. We love you. We appreciate you. We appreciate this table.
Yes.
Bless you forever. Amen.
Do we all have the communion cups? Is anyone in need of a communion cup at this time? Has anyone been overlooked who wishes to participate in our communion service? All right. Back that top covering. For I deliver unto you that which was delivered unto me, that on the night in which was betrayed, Jesus took bread after having given thanks. He broke it and said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Let us eat together." Challenge to get the second cup. Like Mary took also the cup, after having blessed it, he said, "This is the new covenant in my blood. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us drink. Father and Son and the Holy Spirit. The Bible says that they sang a hymn and went out. So let us be likewise. This is the verse of amazing grace. Give God some praise. Oh, y'all can praise God better than that. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you. We want to thank you for coming out and joining the supper with us. We want to let you know that service starts at 10:30 next week, and we hope to see you here. We hope that the message given to you today will carry you throughout the week and strengthen you, and may the Holy Spirit be with you. Because we're still in the midst of this pandemic, of course, we will now collect the offerings at the door. The ushers will be there to take your offering. And once again, may God bless you. And may you continue to strive in the works of the Lord and spread the good news that God is still on our side. Thank you.